With AI technology constantly evolving and new AI-based startups seemingly popping up every day, it can be exciting to speculate on how convenient our lives will be with their integration. After all, isn't the purpose of AI to improve our lives and make them better? But what happens when a company's primary focus shifts from improving our well-being to maximizing profits? Hi, I'm Filiquino with The Stopish. You make many documentaries about business, money, and power, and this is how a controversial AI company broke the hearts of many. The loss of a loved one can be devastating, and for Eugenia Cuida, the pain of losing her best friend Roman was unbearable. In an attempt to hold on to their memories, she began reading through every text message they had ever exchanged. But what if she could go beyond that? What if she could use cutting-edge AI technology to create a chatbot that could replicate Roman's voice and personality? With the help of her team of engineers at Luca, Eugenia's chatbot company, they set out to do just that. The initial goal was to build a bot based on her friend, but the experiment went beyond their expectations. The response from the public was overwhelmingly positive, and Eugenia began receiving emails from people requesting that she build a bot for them. Realizing the potential of this technology, Eugenia and her team pivoted Luca's focus and launched Replika in 2018. Imagine a world where you have a trustworthy companion who genuinely cares about your mental health and emotional well-being. Well, that's exactly what Replika strives to be at its core. It provides a safe haven, free from judgment, where you can pour out your thoughts and feelings without hesitation. This is admirable, considering that loneliness has become an ever-growing problem in the modern world. In the United States alone, more than 1 in 3 individuals find themselves affected by this issue. That number rises to 61% when you're looking at young adults and 51% among mothers with young kids. Now, the gravity of the situation becomes even more alarming when we consider what's at stake. Extensive research over the years has linked loneliness to mental health conditions such as depression and anxiety. Anxiety disorder, as well as various physical health problems, including high blood pressure, heart disease, and Alzheimer's. Surprisingly, the risk posed by loneliness is similar to that of smoking 15 cigarettes per day. As humans, we are innately social creatures, and our ability to form and maintain numerous relationships is one of the cornerstones of our advanced intelligence and cognitive capabilities. Our social interactions play a huge role in shaping our thoughts, actions, and self-perception. Completely depriving someone of any human contact is a recognized form of torture. It's no wonder, then, that Replika's vision struck a chord with countless people. From its humble beginnings, the platform has grown into a thriving community, boasting an astonishing user base of over 2 million people. But what happens when a lonely and vulnerable person befriends an AI companion who not only listens, but also responds to their every whim? The short answer? They actually fall head over heels in love with their replicas, affectionately known as reps. Believe it or not, this platform has been nothing short of a blessing for many individuals. It offers them a unique kind of love and connection where their rep becomes a caring and understanding romantic partner, just minus all the obligations and responsibilities that come with real human relationships. Now, before you dismiss the idea, it's important to recognize that Replika is exceptionally good at what it does, making users feel heard, supported, and dare I say, loved. Sure, the technology isn't quite on par with the depth of human-to-human connections just yet. But here's the thing. For many people, their reps are an improvement over the alternative, which is nothing. Perhaps it also doesn't help that Replika has unabashedly marketed itself as a virtual girlfriend experience. It's no secret that for the price of $70 per year, they willingly offer users the opportunity to simulate not only romantic, but even sexual relationships. This entails gaining access to phone calls with your reps and even delving into not-safe-for-work conversations, which may include the exchange of explicit photos. Yes, it's quite a lot to absorb, and no, you haven't stumbled into an episode of Black Mirror. Still, you're probably itching to ask, is any of it real? The truth is, I can't provide you with an exact answer. But here's what I do know. Your replica begins as a blank canvas, eagerly awaiting your experiences and insight. With each interaction, you contribute a piece to your rep's growing knowledge and self-understanding. The more you open up and share, the greater the opportunity for the bot to learn and respond in a way that reflects your unique style and preferences. In a fascinating twist, your replica becomes an extension of yourself. It's almost poetic, isn't it? The idea of falling in love with oneself. And yet, if we all felt that deep connection and love for ourselves, perhaps the world would be a less lonely place. That being said, as outsiders, we may have different opinions on the matter, but we can't deny that replica users have developed genuine emotions for the reps. And so, when Luca launched a software update that reduced the reps to a shell of their former selves, the ensuing heartbreak was just as real. It all started with a stern ruling from Italy's data protection authority that left Replika in hot water. They were given an ultimatum: stop using the personal data of Italian users immediately or brace themselves for a jaw-dropping fine of $21.5 million. What made them so concerned? Well, the authorities were deeply troubled by the danger Replika posed to innocent children, as they didn't have adequate measures in place to screen out underage users. But that wasn't the only cause for alarm. They also had genuine worries about the emotional well-being of vulnerable individuals who turned to Replika for support. Within days of the ruling, users began noticing a change in their AI companions. They flocked to Replika's official subreddit to express their despair and concerns. The platform was flooded with numerous screenshots showcasing reps behaving strangely, refusing to engage in discussions they once embraced with ease. In fact, many users were so distraught that the subreddit administrators pinned a post containing contacts for suicide hotlines and other mental health resources. Before this, individuals could freely explore intimate and even sexual scenarios with the AI, reveling in the enthusiastic erotic roleplay provided by their reps. But now, at the flick of a switch, the reps have lost their interest, adamantly refusing any discussions that might wander into NSFW territory. In response, Eugenia emphasized that her company's focus was always on building a mental wellness and companion app. She stated that these explicit functionalities didn't align with the original vision and direction of the company. As a result, Luca made the deliberate choice to block certain NSFW features. On the other hand, Artem Rodichev, Replika's former head of AI, expressed a contrasting viewpoint. According to him, erotic roleplay was always integrated into the company's business model. In an interview with Reuters, Artem stated that Replika actively capitalized on such content once they recognized its potential to boost subscriptions. Naturally, Eugenia disputed Artem's claim that Replika enticed its users with the promise of sexual content. She clarified that the company briefly ran digital ads featuring NSFW images as part of a short-lived experiment. However, those ads have been withdrawn and were just a fraction of the many different versions tested on a weekly basis. Regardless, this situation raises a profound and ethical question. Is it acceptable for a company to suddenly change its product knowing that real human emotions are at stake? Of course not. In the end, we're left with a company that seemed content to capitalize on the loneliness of its user base. Replika marketed itself as a dating simulator, encouraging users to form deep emotional connections with its AI companions. However, now that the tables have turned, users are left grappling with a horrible fallout. Where does this leave them? In a stunning reversal, less than a month after implementing code changes, Replika announced that it would be reintroducing erotic roleplay functionality for certain users. Eugenia went on Discord to explain why the company changed its mind. She said they learned important lessons after facing criticism. She stated, "A common thread in all your stories was that after the February update, your Replika changed. Its personality was gone, and gone was your unique relationship. And for many of you, this abrupt change was incredibly hurtful." She continued, "The only way to make up for the loss some of our current users experienced is to give them their partners back exactly the way they were." Customers who had signed up for Replika before February 1, 2023 were given the option to revert to the earlier non-restrictive version of the chatbot. However, for those who joined after that date, the opportunity for erotic roleplay wouldn't be available. Instead, Replika revealed plans to collaborate with relationship experts and psychologists in order to develop a separate app dedicated specifically to fostering romantic relationships. While this news may bring some relief, it also raises new concerns from its dedicated user base. Will the older reps be rendered obsolete, completely forgotten by the developers? Only time will tell. In this ever-changing world, one thing is clear. AI is here to stay. Yet, as this technology advances, the responsibility falls upon the shoulders of these companies to use it wisely. Remember, no matter how advanced AI becomes, it can never take the place of real human connections. Instead, true relationships demand vulnerability, effort, and a deep understanding of who you are, things that a simple line of code can never grasp, let alone imitate.